What I have here is an ultra small form factor Optiplex 9020 that came with a low wattage i3, but can it be upgraded to a regular i7 with 8 threads? I have an extra i7 4770 laying around, so I thought I'd give it a shot. If it does work, it'll definitely run hot, so we'll just have to find a way to keep it cool, probably lap the heatsink. So, as I said, the i3 that came with it is a 4160T, which only has 2 cores and 4 total threads, but it only has a 35-watt TDP. Now I'm going to try and install this i7-4770 with 4 cores and 8 total threads. It does have a TDP that's rated at 84 watts. Now the power supply has been repaired in the past, and I believe this is the original one, which only outputs upwards of 65 watts, so we'll see how well this works, but I might need to find a higher wattage brick. Swapping the CPUs is the easy part. Now, something I noticed is that this heatsink appears to have already been sanded down, so someone's been in here before. But will it post with the i7? Alright, let's see what it can do. We got something. Thought it wasn't going to work for a second. And it's booting. Okay. Alright, so the resolution's off. There it goes, it recognized the GPU. And right now, we are idling around 50 degrees Celsius. So I have XMRig running, and so here's the CPU. You can see it's all there. It's firing up 4 of the cores, because the rest are just threads. And it's sitting at 3 gigahertz. So it's not going up to 3.4, so it might be thermal throttling, or that's all this thing can do. But as you can see, even with that, and it's only running 50% because it's only using 4 cores, we're looking at 75 and it's climbing. Well, let's give it a chance. I may need a more powerful power supply, but even with it running at a lower speed, it's still going to be better than the i3. And as you can see, after a couple minutes, it's already up in the 80s and it's heading towards 90, and it's not happy. So first thing I'm going to do is pull up the heatsink, and we'll sand it down and make sure that that's nice and flat, put it back in and see what it does. And then if we have to, I can pull the blue wire off of the fan connector and we can make this fan run full speed, which it should be doing already, but you know, that's Dell for you. Now something I didn't even notice before, this one's already been sanded down, so we're not gonna be able to do too much, but I'll sand it even more. We'll see how, you know, how far it'll go. Okay, so I got it knocked down quite a bit. As you can see, there's still a little bit of the paint there, but that's actually past the CPU socket itself, so I'm not too worried about that. You probably can't see this on the camera, but this thing is pretty warped, which it's on springs, so these things have little springs on them, so it'll, as long as the center is flat and it lays down on the CPU, the others really don't matter too much. It'll work its way through. I'm going to put it on some finer sandpaper, clean it up a little bit. We'll add a little bit of water, kind of wet sand it, kind of, I'm not going to go for a mirror shine, but we're just going to clean it up a little bit and see what we can get. All right, well, I don't know how well you can see that on camera, but it looks pretty good to me. It's not a mirror finish, and yes, there is, you know, some scratches in there, just a little bit, but it's very smooth. And it's far better than these things come stock. These things come stock, if you run it just one time across a piece of sandpaper, you'll see all these low spots and high spots. So it's far better than it was stock. So what I am going to do, like I've done elsewhere, I have little washers that I'm going to put on these screws above the spring. It just gives it just a little bit more pressure, downward pressure, holding the heatsink down. First, let's just see how it does, if there's any difference. And I'm sure it's still going to get very, very hot. I just want to see if it heats up any slower. All right, right off the bat, we're in the low 40s, high 30s. That's good. That's good. And actually, already, it's only running a few seconds, really, under a minute, but it's heating up much slower than it was. It's still only running at 3 gigahertz. So I'm going to let this run for, I don't know, 5-10 minutes, and we'll come back and see what it looks like. So it's only been a couple minutes, as you can see, and we're in the low to mid 70s, which we were before, but it's getting there much slower. So we're doing good. We're doing good. But let's try this. We're going to pull this out and very quickly take out the blue wire. And that's going to be the control wire. That is going to run it at full speed. Yeah, it's annoying, I know. I'm going to put that there. I don't want it shortened on anything, so it's kind of stupid. Don't do this. Let's put that on. Yeah, I can feel a lot of heat coming out of there. Are we up at 3.3? We're up at 3.4 now. How did that happen? 3.36. Oh, it's getting there. All right, so let's run the miner again and see what happens. So it's down to 3 gigahertz again, probably because it probably just doesn't have the power to run it, and that's fine. We know that. That's fine. All right, I'll let this run a few minutes, and we'll see if increasing the fan speed helps any, if it keeps it, you know, below the crucial zone. It's going to be hot. Well, let's see if it keeps it down, you know, maybe below 80. All right, so it's been around, I don't know, what, 5 minutes or so, 5 or 6 minutes, and we're still sitting at low 60s. So I think we're doing good. Yeah, it is showing 45% usage. It's because the miner's only using the four cores. It's got 8 threads total, but it's using the 4 cores. And we are only sitting at 3 gigahertz. So this isn't really the right CPU for this. I can try later on if I can find another power adapter. This is only a 65 watt, and this thing is pretty toasty, I'm not gonna lie. And you can even feel the heat coming off the top of the case here. But it is staying in the low 60s, so with the fan maxed out. So with a more aggressive fan profile, you could definitely use this. Now, really, a slower i7 would have been you know, a better bet for this lower wattage. This is what I had on hand. I'm not using it. Figured, why not throw it in here and just use it? So yeah, obviously this PC isn't using the CPU to its full potential, but let's see how it performs even in its handicapped or throttled state. In PCMark, the CPU test shows it performing almost twice as well as the stock i3. The memory test shows the i7 scoring slightly higher. In the Cinebench single-threaded test, they look about the same, but the i7 does pull ahead and finishes about 5 minutes sooner. In the multi-threaded test, there's no comparison. The i7, even throttled, finishes nearly in half the time. Now for 3D, I used Heaven, and the i7 technically got a higher score, but as you can see by just watching it, there's all sorts of stuttering, and it just doesn't look good. So if I want to use this i7 in this little PC, I'm going to have to find a, you know, better power adapter. So yeah, I know, not too exciting, but I was going to do it anyways. Thought I'd film it and post it. Hope everyone had a great holiday, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.